Since the beginning of the service today, right from praises and worship, ordinary songs, through the offerings and tithes, everything that we've gone through, we have seen the presence of God with us here today.
Yes.
Though the time is not by our side this moment, I'm going to take only but 3 minutes.
Amen.
Because we are having a lot still to do today. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I just want to remind us of one or two things. I don't know about your life today. What I wanted to speak on is all about having delivered you from the trouble that you've been in it. It is all about deliverance from trouble. If you want to take a look at your life today, you will notice that maybe trouble has been looking for you. Maybe you had trouble before. Maybe some other person close to you or far from you must have made you uncomfortable because of one thing or the other, and that decided to pose a kind of threat to your faith. But the word today says you have God who will deliver you from all that trouble. Many a times when trouble comes to you, more especially if you are a man of God or somebody that has been going to the church, and people will begin to think and say that, why must this person be having this kind of trouble? To you yourself, maybe you must have fulfilled the word of God. Maybe you have fulfilled the covenant of God. But the trouble and temptation, tribulation, turbulence have been raging around your faith. Just have in mind that you have a God that will always set you free from all that trouble. And today, when you take a look at your house that you live, maybe a wife or husband, you went ahead and married a woman that you look at her as an angel, and when you get to the house, she turned to be a devil. You are not the first. Maybe you go and marry a husband that you look at him as a saint, and when you get to the house, he pull a packet of cigarettes and start smoking. And you will say, why does this happen to me? You are not the first. Many a times, children of God will have different trouble. But all you have to have in your mind is that I know that the Lord that liveth will always see me through from that trouble in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It does not end there. When you take a look at what happened to the children of Israel when they came out of the land of Egypt, on their own journey, they kept going and they came to a particular point. When they look back, they see the Egyptians following them. And they look by the side, they see the mountains. And they look at their front, and they see the Red Sea. And they are being caught in the middle. And they didn't have anywhere to go. But they remember that they have God. And the God that they had says that, fear not, I am with you. And at the end of the day, the Lord Almighty opened the way for them. And they are no longer being caught in the middle. The same thing happened to you in your life today. If you were caught in the middle, at wherever that you are going, or whatever thing that you are doing, but remember that you have a God that will always see you through and open a way right in front of you, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, when you, if you have your Bible with you, turn to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. That particular passage says that there had no temptation taken you but such as is common to men. To each and every trouble that you are having today in your life is common to men. Your own is not special. Others have been going through that and they always come out very free. Today you might have a financial trouble. Others have been having like that and they always come out of it. You are not the first. Maybe you have planned to have a business run with somebody and that person take the money and eat it off without conscience. You are not the first. And then maybe you are going to school, you try exam in one way or the other, you couldn't pass, you are not the first. That has been happening to people. And that reminded you to understand that there is no temptation beyond what God can always do it for you. And then by the time that you have a temptation, by the time that you have trial and tribulation, do not forget that the Lord is right there with you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Along the line, so many people, when they got into a particular trouble, and they will be thinking, how will I do in order to get out of this trouble? And they started telling one another, it is not your position. When you have problems, then you go around to tell people. Then you got to go right back to your own house and then kneel down in prayer and ask God to see you through. Something happened in the life of Daniel when the king said that each and everyone got to obey him and do what he was asking to. And then Daniel knew that he is a man of God. He can never succumb to that kind of power because it's not from God. And then Daniel went right back to his own house and then go to the upper house. The upper house is the house that one can sit down and pray. And open the window to the upper house. And that window was going straight to Jerusalem, which we know as the Holy City. And when he stayed there in the upper house, I begin to pray and petition this matter to God. And by the time that he petitioned the matter to God, and at the end of the day, he went out of that trouble without having any problem. We are familiar with the story of Daniel. And today, you might have one or two of those problems. But I can always tell you that the Lord says that it's common to men. Your own is not special, that he will always be with you. As long as you've been going to the house of the Lord, keep on praying, asking God to do one thing or the other for you, he will always remember you. And that's why, like what the responsible elder had just said about the building that we're having at hand, and you know that you are committed to build for God. There is no way you do that as your own personal thing and God will never see you through. By the time you take upon your shoulder to contribute, to make sure you build for God, anytime you have a problem and you go ahead and ask God to remember you, to remember what you've done for him, he will always remember you. He will always see you through from any kind of trouble that you will have in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So my brothers and sisters today, I don't want to take you too far. I just want to remind you to understand that whatsoever problem that you might have, whatsoever trouble that you might have, is common to man. You are not the first. If you go through that, just understand that you have God that will always see you through. We ask God Almighty to come in and make this word to be in our mind, rather to exhibit and continue to do it all I ask in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
There is nothing that my God cannot do. There is nothing that my God cannot do. He healed the sick and raised the dead. There is nothing that my God can do. Hallelujah. There's nothing that my God cannot do. There's nothing that my God cannot do. That my God cannot do. He healed the sick and raised the dead. There is nothing that my God cannot do.
Hallelujah. Bow down our heads for prayers. Thank you, Lord, for who you are. Thank you for the word of hope that you have given unto us, that you will deliver us from all the evil men, all the barriers and obstacles on our way for us to live and glorify you. Take glory in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I commit the speaker of that word today, O Lord, unto you. should reveal him back with the Holy Spirit and more word of comfort and faith to give out to these sheep. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. 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 Thanksgiving time. Hallelujah.